But here's what the great law says. It does not say if you need, you will reap. That's not what it says. Someone says, well, I really need to reap. Then you must learn the basic law. And without education, see, you'll be left behind. Here's what it says. In order to reap, you must plant. Guess who deserves to reap? Those who plant. So could I deserve something unique and valuable? Yes, if you understand the law, if you understand how it works in your own self-interest. We must plant. We must give to the soil. We must turn it loose. We must let it do its work. We must have patience, take care of it. Now we deserve the reaping. If you need, you must plant. Next, if you need to find, in your own self-interest, if you need to find, here's what it says, you must search to find. Finding is reserved for those that search. They're the ones that deserve it. Somebody who says, well, this person really needs to find a good idea, then they must go searching. You must go to the library. You must go to the seminars. You must go to the sermon. You must go to and listen to the lyrics of the song. You must go to where education is being taught. You must go to where good ideas are being shared. Go to, go to. Rarely does a good idea interrupt you. Rarely. Good ideas are like mining for gold. You got to develop the mental machinery to go look, go look, go sifting, go searching, go looking. And if you search, what? You will find the promise is there for everyone in their own self-interest. You'll find all you need to find. If you search for it, you'll find everything you need for your health, everything you need for a flourishing lifestyle, everything you need for a good marriage, everything you need to strengthen your friendship, everything you need for economics. You will find if you'll do like you did today. Spend a couple of days searching, taking a look, seeing if someone has some good ideas to share. All things are conditional. God says, I'm an amateur on God, but God says, if you'll move toward me, what? I will move toward you. It's always conditional. Which could also be translated, God says, you don't move, I don't move. You say, well, that's arbitrary. Well, when you're God, you can set it up that way. Remember, your planet, you can rearrange all this. Change it all. But on this one, here's what's interesting. What you move toward tends to move toward you. If you move toward education, education starts to seek you out. This is one of the unique positive mysteries. Whatever you move toward moves toward you. If you move toward progress, progress seems to want to now embrace you, move toward you. All life seems to wish to reward its benefactor. If you become the benefactor, you'll receive these incredible rewards. If you're the benefactor to the garden, the flowers seem to bloom and say, look at me, look how bright and beautiful I am because you took care of me. I wish to reward you by being beautiful, lovely, spectacular. Your own children, if you become their benefactor, they want to reward you with their progress. I taught my daughters how to swim, right? My daughters would say, and to dive. And my daughters would say, Daddy, watch, watch. Look, look, watch. Look what you've created here. I mean, you've spent the time with me and, you know, when it didn't go well, now look at me. This is the payoff. Watch me dive. I was their benefactor. Now, all life wishes to respond to the benefactor. Those who give their time, give their effort, give their patience, give their ideas, the benefit of their experience. Now, whatever has benefited from that wishes to respond. The crop wishes to grow. The child wishes to show you how much progress they've made. That is so exciting. Otherwise, the wisdom is wasted. Otherwise, the emotion soon passes. Unless you put it into a disciplined activity, capture it. Disciplines is called how to capture the emotion and how to capture the wisdom and translate it into equity. Disciplines. Now, here's what's important about disciplines. All disciplines affect each other. In fact, here's a good philosophical phrase. Everything affects everything else. Nothing stands alone. Don't be naive in saying, well, this doesn't matter. I'm telling you, everything matters. There are some things that matter more than others, but there isn't anything that doesn't matter. Okay. We all pity the man who says, Well, this is the only place I let down. Not true. Key to take home: every letdown affects the rest of your performance. Every letdown affects the rest. This is part of the educational process on personal development. If you don't take the walk around the block, you probably won't do the apple a day. If you don't do the apple a day, you probably won't start building your library. If you don't build your library, you probably won't keep a journal, and you won't take pictures, and you won't do this, you won't do wise things with your money, won't do wise things with your time, won't do wise things with your possibilities and relationships. And the first thing you know, 6 years of that accumulated, and we say you have messed up. So the whole key to reversing that process now is to start picking up these disciplines. Now here's the positive side. Every new discipline affects the rest of your disciplines. Every new one affects the rest. That's why action is so important. The least action, the smallest action. Take it. Because when you start accomplishing and the value starts to return from that one action, it'll inspire you to do the next one and the next one and the next one. You start walking around the block, it'll inspire you to get an apple. Get an apple, it'll inspire you to get a book. Get a book, it'll inspire you to get a journal. Get a journal, it'll inspire you to grow, develop some skills. All disciplines affect each other. Every lack affects the rest. Every new affects the rest. The key is to diminish the lack and set up the new, and you've started a whole new life process. Key. Also, one more thought on discipline. Here's the greatest value of discipline: self-worth, self-esteem. People are teaching self-esteem these days, but they don't connect it to disciplines. The least lack of discipline, and it starts to erode our psyche. One of the greatest temptations is to just ease up a little bit, right? The slightest lack of doing your best starts to erode the psyche. Instead of doing your best, doing just a little less than your best. Sure enough, you say, well, it's just going to affect my sales. No, it's going to affect your consciousness. It's going to affect your philosophy. Now you've begun in the slightest way to affect your own philosophy. Here's the problem with the least neglect. Neglect starts as an infection, and if you don't take care of it, it becomes a disease. And one neglect leads to another. And the worst of all, when neglect starts, it diminishes our self-worth, our self-confidence, our self-value. You say, well, how can I get back my self-respect? I'm telling you, you don't have to go to 29 classes. All you have to do is start the smallest discipline that now corresponds to your own philosophy, like I should. And I could, and I will. No longer will I let neglect stack up on me so that I will have the sorry scenario 6 years from now, giving some excuse instead of celebrating my progress. That's the key to discipline. Okay? Let's get kids involved in the least of disciplines. One more, and then one more, and then another one, and then another one, and then some more. And the first thing you know, you're starting to weave the tapestry of a disciplined life into which you can pour more wisdom and more attitude and more strong feeling, more faith and more courage. Now you've got something, a vessel in which to put it. And now the equities start to flow. And the early return, I'm telling you, if you'll start this process, the early return will have you so excited. You'll commit yourself to this strategy for the rest of your life.